Now, let's meet the starting lineups for today's contest. First, for the Lady Jaguars, Edgar, 5'11" sophomore from Richmond, Mississippi. Number two, Alaric Scott. Edgar, a 5'7" senior from White Castle, Louisiana. Number four, Skylar LeBear. Edgar, a 5'6" senior from New Orleans, Louisiana. Number five, Danae Charles. Edgar, a 5'10" senior from Fort Lauderdale, Florida. Number 11, Rashani Cowell. And Edgar, a 5'9" junior from Westlake, Louisiana. Number 24, Jake Towner. The Lady Jaguars are coached by Carlos Funches.
The starting lineup for your Grambling State University Lady Tigers. At center, a 6'3" freshman from Woodbridge, Virginia. Number one, Jasmine Forte. At guard, a 5'7" senior from Little Rock, Arkansas. Number two, Shekinah Hill. At guard, 5'10" sophomore from Baton Rouge, Louisiana. Number 12, Justice Coleman. At guard, a 5'8" junior from Birmingham, Alabama. Number
Shot up no good. And Grambling doing a great job in getting to the boards. Here's a rebound. Justice Coleman once again. And a timeout on the floor by the Lady Jags. It's a 30-second timeout. Grambling on top right now by the score of 11-2. We'll take this timeout here on the Grambling Sports Radio Network. We'll be right back.
Welcome back here to the Frederick C. Hobby Assembly Center here on the campus of Grambling State University. Lady Tigers right now on top of Southern University 11-2 with 7:08 remaining here in this first quarter of play. One substitution in the ballgame. Forte coming back in for Grambling. Three-pointer on the way up and good. And that was a hit by Brittany Rose. First 3 points of the ballgame for Brittany Rose. 11-5 now our score. Here's a three-pointer on the way for Grambling. Up no good, but
rebound by Jasmine Forte for the putback.
13-5, now our score. Grambling on top. 6:31 remaining here in the first quarter of play. And that layup good on the inside. Lady Tigers now up 13-7. Shakala Hill with the basketball. Oh, she throws it out of bounds, trying to get the ball up the court.
Still seeing a little bit of that full court pressure from Southern right now.
Southern definitely wants to put full court pressure on Grambling. One of the main reasons is that they know that if Grambling can transition and get down the floor, they run the offense extremely well. And so, of course, Grambling is a pressure team, and teams who press normally don't like to be pressed.
Absolutely, but when they break the press, there's usually tends to be somebody open because the last two times they've broken the press, there's somebody open in the corner on the far side.
13-7 our score, 6:11 remaining first quarter of play in for Southern University. Number 35, and that's Williams, Kaylin Williams now coming in. Shot up, no good, foul coming up against Grambling. It's going to be a two-shot foul as well. Justice Coleman with the foul for Grambling State University. That's her first personal. Free throw is up and good. One more free throw attempt at the line here for Skylar O'Bear, the senior from White Castle, Louisiana, one of the mainstays of this team, and of course, on the all-conference preseason team. And here's a steal here by Southern University after putting on the pressure. Getting the ball out to Courtney Parson. Now to Brittany Rose. Brittany Rose, top of the key, trying to get it to the baseline. Drive, the shot up, no good by Tenaria Moore, the freshman from Baltimore. Grambling coming down the floor, and Southern trying for the steal. Goes out of bounds off of one of the Southern players' foot. It'll be Grambling basketball. Lady Tigers on top 13-9. It was 11-2 at one point. 7-2 run here by the Lady Jags.
And I was just going to say, when it was 11-2, that you talked about setting a tempo early, and I thought they did a good job of that, but it looks like it might be wearing off a little bit right now.
That off the hands of Grambling back to Southern. They're trying to get the ball down deep. that time trying to get it into Jasmine Forte, who's really a big body inside, 6'3", has a lot of body inside to try to get some things going on for Grambling, but Southern University with some quick hands.
And the scary part is she's only a freshman.
Only a freshman. That is scary. Inside now for Southern University to Kaylin Williams. Now back outside. Three-pointer on the way by Courtney Parson. No good. Out of bounds off of Shekala Hill. Now some changes here. Ariel Williams will come in for the Grambling Lady Tigers. Madison Connolly Banks, I believe, also coming in. Transfer from Sinclair College. Inbounds pass to Southern University. And one shot up, no good. To Kara Parsons with the rebound from Grambling. Here comes Shekala Hill. Coast to coast, goes up, and she can't get the shot, but she will go to the free throw line.
Not wanting to shy away from any type of contact.
No, at all. Shyness has not been one of the things that she's really been.
Oh, yeah, not at all. She's not afraid to throw a pass where other people would not even think, really not even consider it.
Now coming into the ball game for Southern University, going to be number 20, Imani McQuain. Of course, she's a freshman. She is from Ruston, Louisiana. Went to Ruston High School, played on that team in Ruston High, had a chance to go to the playoffs. Played quite a few years in AAU basketball leagues, and now starting as a freshman for Southern University. Sandy Pugh thought a lot of her, and she has really upped her game. Cross-court pass. Now inside, great defense there inside by Banks. Getting it to Shekala Hill. Crossover, she goes up for the shot, and she draws the contact. Coach Funchess wants a jump ball, and that foul is going to go against Brittany Rose. That's her first personal.
Two bodies on the inside, and she still went up.
Yep. Kaylin Williams, Brittany Rose, both with fouls so far in the ball game for Southern University. Shot up, no good on the free throw line by Shekala Hill. Had a chance to kind of watch McWayne grow up a little bit here in North Louisiana, watch her play, and of course was an assistant coach on her AAU basketball team for about a year under her dad.
Rare two misses by Shekala Hill at the free throw
Very
line.
Very rare. And a foul coming up against Grambling. That's going to go against Banks, I believe. First personal. Shot up, no good. And recovering the basketball for Grambling, Cameron London. Well, one and done there by Grambling and coming up with the basketball, Southern University. Bounce pass inside. It's going to go to Williams. Shot up and good.
Expect them to keep working the ball inside if those are the type of shots they're going to be getting.
Absolutely. ...14-11 our score, Grambling on top. 3:40 remaining first quarter, and Southern continues on that defense. Shot up, no good by Ariel Williams. One and done on that trip. Shot inside, up, good, and there's going to be a blocking foul against Grambling. Three-point play on the way for Southern University. Shekala Hill with her first personal.
Oh, they're saying ball out of bounds.
Yeah, so not a shooting foul here, which means that the basket's no good.
Gives Grambling a chance to set up their defense.
Now, if the basket is no good, then it's Southern ball out of bounds. But if it's good, it's a possibility for a three-point play. I thought that the basket was good.
Refs are talking about it.
And they're talking about it there on the floor, and now they'll decide what to do here. They are going to count the basket. They're trying to figure this out here. And the official's still kind of talking things over here. This is really an interesting call here because, of course, the shot was up, and you're watching it here on replay if you're watching GSU TV. You could see, of course, one of the players, and it's going to be Tenaria Moore, who went up for the shot. And the basket counted. And as you're watching, if you're watching GSU TV, you could clearly see she was fouled. And then what they wanted, what they were asking or conferring about was that was a pass to the inside. Did the foul happen on the pass or on the shot? If it happened on the pass, there's no basket and they get the ball down low. If it happened on the shot, it's a continuation.
Absolutely.
And that's what we're still trying to see here.
And it looks like they are going to count the basket and give her her plus one.
Because the foul actually looked like it happened on the pass. That's what the confusion was. As Moore was going to the inside, she dished it off. And so they're now going to say that Moore was fouled. Shot is up and it is good. So a three-point play here. It was 11-2 at one point. Grambling on top. It is now tied at 14.
That was actually one thing that they did all of last season. They would have monster first quarters or monster breaks, and then it would just go away. It would just vanish in thin air.
Great camera work there by our crew. And interesting. And shot up and good by Takara Parsons right down on the other end of the floor. Grambling not wasting any time. Southern University with the basketball right now, 16-14, Grambling on top. 3:06 remaining in the opening quarter. Santoria Black, Donovan Travis here for today's basketball game. Shot up and no good off the back of the iron by Brianna Thompson, the 6'2 sophomore from LaPlace. Shakyla, little crossover dribble. Oh, it goes off the foot, but they're going to call a foul against Southern University. It's going to be charged. Towner will get the foul. That's and it'll be Grambling basketball.
That's her first.
Grambling with the basketball. Shot up, no good. Looked like a foul there. Ariel Williams was mugged on the way up.
Definitely a lot of contact, but not enough to draw a whistle.
Inside. Ball on the floor. It's going to be against Southern. I believe that foul is going to go against 24, Jaden Towner. That'll be her second personal. And you can see there where Towner trying to dive on the floor there, getting the foul. And I don't know, you know, almost it was almost incidental contact as you're watching the replay. She did get the left hand on, she did get the left hand on Parsons, and Parsons is at the free throw line shooting.
That's her second foul in as many seconds just about, so you expect her to come out, and she does.
...17-14 now the score. Drive and the shot is up and good. Skylar O'Bare not afraid to go in for the bucket. Shakyla Hill now controlling the basketball. Hill has played in 14 games this year. Averaging 18.8 points per game and one of the tops in the conference. Shot up and good. That is number 15, Candace Paramore. Paramore, the 5'7 freshman from Garland, Texas. Ball lost, over and back violation on Southern, and a careless turnover. 19-16. Grambling on top with 1:28 remaining in the first quarter. Turnover there by Southern, or by Grambling.
Coleman was looking for Shaquilla Hill right there, but wasn't open, just smothered.
And a missed shot there by Southern University, and the ball will go back. Nice crossover, but couldn't get the bucket. Southern with the basketball inside. Nice pass on the inside. That's Brianna Thompson. 6'2 sophomore from LaPlace getting the shot. Tigers have been shooting pretty well, and here is the shot up and good, and there's going to be a timeout by Grambling with 30 seconds remaining here in this first quarter of play. 21-18, Grambling on top. Tigers, of course, will have another home game coming up on Monday as they'll take on Alcorn State University. Game time will be at 5:30 for the women and 7:30 for the men. Make sure that you come on out and support Lady Tiger and men's basketball from the Frederick C. Hobby Assembly Center. Of course, both these teams trying to do better and repeat and go higher than they did last year. Men, of course, won the regular season crown, now eligible to go to the tournament this year. Women won the tournament. And they want to get it all. They want to win the tournament and the regular season.
Absolutely. If you look at all the preseason stats and all the preseason talk, Grambling is expected to win out everything as far as basketball. So I don't know if the coaches believe in living up to the hype or even pay attention to the hype, but there are definitely high hopes for both teams this year.
Yep, definitely. Looking at some of these young ladies, you know, they have to make a difference here that are being asked to step up. You know, you got some shoes to fill from last year, no question about that. But Shaquilla Hill, who's averaging almost 19 points a ball game, is been one of those players that's really helped out, averaging almost a little over 7 rebounds a game as well. Shot up by Brittany Rose, no good. Ball tipped around. Shaquilla Hill with the rebound. Three-pointer on the way by Paramore to end the quarter.
They called it a two.
Call it a two-point bucket. Grambling scores 23-18. We'll take this timeout. The Grambling Lady Tigers on top 23-18. We'll take this timeout on the Grambling Sports Radio Network.
We'll be right back.
The Tigers getting ready to come out, getting their final instructions from head coach Freddie Murray.
And the features make it 100 times.
Kyler Murray with 3 points so far in this ball game. They'll take the ball out of bounds as we start this second quarter.
News, the KGRM radio station,
wait for the officials here.
Campus events,
about ready to start.
Weather, and more. There's even a map that'll show you exactly where you are on campus so that you can get to where you need to be. In your free time, you can stay up to date with the latest social media posts from the Grambling State University Instagram, Facebook.
Back here at the Frederick C. Hobby Assembly Center here on the campus of Grambling State University. Grambling with the basketball to start this second quarter. 23-18 is the score right now. Inside pass. Taken away. That ball goes out of bounds off of Southern, and we'll go back to Grambling. Lady Tigers won 80-72 against Alabama State, and then turn around and won 63-51. Aside from the loss against Oklahoma State, they had won. They've won 5 out of the last 6 ball games, going all the way back to Indiana. They won that game, 65-62, a 1-point win against Loyola Marymount. Well, they have really been on the move. 5 out of 6, they're trying to make it 6 out of 7. Justice Coleman with the basketball, top of the key. Now we'll drive inside the paint, trying to get it off the window. Up, no good, and it goes out of bounds. Back to Southern University. 23-18 our score, Grambling on top. 9:09 remaining here in the first half of play. Coming into the contest now for the Lady Tigers, I should say, will be Yancey, the 5'10 junior from Ashburn, Georgia. Southern with the basketball. Charles will control. Skylar O'Bear is their leading scorer, trying to get the ball in her hands, and that's where it is right now. O'Bear has the basketball, trying to move around the zone. She'll take a 3-point shot up, drains it. And that is why she's Southern University's leading scorer.
You saw Shakyla Hill was actually trying to direct traffic on defense, and she just shifted to the side and was able to get that three off no problem.
And they're doubling on her, leaving Grambling wide open on the 3-point line. That's 21, Cameron London. And that's one of the things that Coach Funches said he wanted to do is double down on Shakyla Hill in the zone, but you got to be careful because you leave somebody open out there on the perimeter and they can shoot threes.
And especially if the ball is in Shakyla Hill's hand and being double-teamed, she's not afraid to throw it cross court.
Skylar O'Bear with another 3-pointer. She has 10 points now for the Lady Jaguars. 26-24, Grambling on top. Cross court pass. Another 3-pointer on the way. This time, no good. Like Cameron London. And here comes Southern University. Charles to Skylar O'Bear. Another 3-pointer. Good. 9 straight for Skylar O'Bear to start the second quarter, and Southern with their first lead of the ball game, 27-26. My goodness. You cannot leave O'Bear open. She is the 3-point threat for this basketball team. And that's going to be a foul charge to Southern, much to the disliking of the entire coaching staff.
And a lot of the bench as well.
Yeah. McGee with the foul. Ball will be taken out of bounds. Cameron London. Foul coming up on Southern at Skylar O'Bear. Her second personal.
And you talked about Skylar O'Bear, you know, 9 straight points. It looks like Coach Murray is actually going with a much smaller lineup to try and combat the perimeter game.
Got to guard O'Bear, that's for sure.
Absolutely.
You got somebody knocking down 16-17 a game. Jump ball, nice defense on the inside by Southern University. O'Bear tying the ball up, and it goes back to Southern. Lady Tigers on trailing by 1.
26-24.
Ball goes inside.
And no good. Skylar, I should say, on the inside. That was Cowart. She misses the bucket. And coming in with the basketball is Shakala Hill. Now a three-pointer on the way by Yancey. Good. They'll give her a two-pointer. Yancey now with 4 points. 6:42 remaining here in this first half of play. Grambling on top, 28-27. Nice defense on the inside. Takara Parsons with great hands. Here comes Shakala Hill. She'll drive, she'll shoot, she'll draw the foul. And one of the reasons why she leads the team in free throw percentage, she is not afraid to go to the inside.
You talk about going inside. They're trying to get the ball inside for a lot of the game, but it's just not working out for them, as really Southern is just clogging all the passing lanes.
Absolutely.
Like, there's very rare spots where you'll see the ball go in the inside and there's not at least two bodies in powder blue. And another miss for Shakyla at the free throw line. Oh, yeah, my rare. Goodness.
A couple of substitutions in here for Southern University. They'll bring in Tanera Moore. And they will also bring in Brittany Rose. Free throw up and good. Lady Tigers on top, 29-27. To the Lady Jaguars, 6:12 remaining here in this first half of play. Santoria Black, Donovan Travis on Sports Talk 97.7 as well as on GSU TV, bringing you this women's basketball game. Southern miss and a offensive rebound. Now, Shakala Hill trapped down there a little bit, and the ball is knocked out of her hands, and it goes back to Grambling.
Missed two easy layups on that drive right there.
Wow.
You know, it's one thing to miss it. You think you got all free if you're Grambling and then miss again. That's just a bad day for Southern.
It's going to be a foul on Southern. Kyla Hill leads not only the team in scoring, but leads the conference in scoring at 18.8 points a game. Mean stuff on the inside. Justice Coleman going up, can't hit the shot. Shot up, and is it good?
Now they call it on the floor.
Yancey went up for the shot. Now, wait a minute. They haven't determined whether that basket was good or not.
At first, they said it was on the floor, but now they're only saying one free throw.
Shot up, no good.
So it was an and one, but just couldn't capitalize on the one free throw.
Skylar O'Bear averaging 10.8 points a game, 11th in scoring in the conference. Shakala Hill number one. Jasmine Boyd is actually in the top 10 in scoring at number 8.
Grambling is missing her in action this game.
Absolutely. Cameron London, great defense. Nice job on the switch. That was a nice job by Southern setting up the pick. And it allowed Brittany Rose to come around the pick on the free throw line and get an easy shot.
Ooh.
Nice pass.
Just tipped.
It was just tipped. Brittany Rose coming away with it. Pearson with the basketball. Shot up. No, it's going to be a foul coming up here. It is a shooting foul. And we have a timeout on the floor. 31-29 our score. Grambling on top. 4:43 remaining in this first half of play. We'll take this timeout. You're listening to the Grambling Sports Radio Network and watching live on GSU TV. Welcome back here to the Frederick C. Hobby Assembly Center on the campus of GSU. 31-29 our score. 4:43 remaining in this first half of play. Donovan, if you had to look at this first half, Grambling storms out 11-2. Southern comes back, ties it up, and it's been relatively close throughout.
Right, so I don't know what Coach Funches for Southern was telling them after that first time out when they were down 11-2, but whatever it was, Southern definitely got the message and definitely come back, and now we have a much more competitive game than what we thought when it first started.
Lady Jags at the free throw line. Shot up and good. One more free throw attempt up and good. 31-31 now the score, 4:43 remaining here in this first quarter of play. The first half of play. Yancey doing a great job in getting her footing so she didn't get the charge. Oh, she slips. Slips and turns the basketball over. Southern University goes in and gets the bucket on transition. And now Southern with the lead, 33-31, 4:28 remaining in the first half. The ball nearly stolen, and it is by Southern University. Coming away with it is Moore. Ball goes out of bounds off of Grambling and back to Southern. Boy, I'm telling you, Southern University, a four-point swing right there, getting the bucket, and then, of course, an unfortunate slip by Yancey, and Southern recovers the basketball. Controlling the basketball, Parson goes in for the shot, no good. Oh, they're going to call a foul on Takara Parsons.
Wow. Really?
I tell you what, the Lady Tigers right now, which had a lead, Southern University really turning up the pressure and the intensity, especially on the offensive end. What you're seeing is Southern University really dominating more on the inside, getting positioning inside the paint, trying to get second chance opportunities.
Right, and when you first started talking about the lineups before the game started, you talked about them going with what looked like a four guard, one center type setup, and really they're working the ball inside more than I think either of us expected them to.
Absolutely. A near steal there. Nice job by Shakala Hill. Nearly picked the pocket of Brittany Rose. Rose, three-pointer on the way. Good. 36-31 now. Southern on top. 3:36 remaining here in the first half of play. London nearly turned the ball over. She gets it to Justice Coleman. Coleman turns the ball over. That's going to be a foul. Alaric Scott controlling. She hasn't really been a huge factor in the ball game so far, but Southern will get the basketball. 36-31 the score. Grambling trailing. After leading pretty much the entire game until about 5 minutes or so remaining in the second quarter. With the basketball for Southern is Charles. She gets it out to Lyric Scott. Shot up no good, and losing the ball temporarily was Banks. It's all on the floor. Jump ball possession goes to Grambling. Banks, a 6'1 junior from Kettering, Ohio. Of course, Ohio, part of the stomping ground of our sports information director, Brian Howard.
And you talked about Southern only getting the lead only a few minutes ago in the game. You can chalk that up to the spark they have from Obert, definitely. 9 straight points?
Yep, 9 straight by Obert. Paramore, a three-pointer up and no good after the pass from Ariel Williams. 2:56 remaining in the first half. Still a five-point deficit for the Lady Tigers. Charles went over momentarily to get some instruction. Three-pointer on the way by Rose. Up no good off the side of the iron. Justice Coleman tried to get the rebound, and right there to get it was Alyric Scott, 5'11 sophomore. Bounce pass inside. That's Kaylin Williams. She goes up for the turnaround jumper. No good. Ariel Williams with the rebound for Grambling. Williams will drive. Oh, tried to drop a bounce pass inside to Connolly Banks, and it goes out of bounds. That's a case where you probably should have just taken it in instead of making that pass. Too many passes there.
Right. I don't think she was expecting to get the ball on that, especially since she was wide open right next to the hoop.
Charles with the basketball. Drives the paint, goes up for the shot, and it's good. The point guard goes in and gets two, 38-31. Grambling with their largest deficit. They're down by seven now with 2:07 remaining in this first half of play. Shekinah Hill, she'll go inside the paint. And it's going to be a jump ball. She tried to draw the foul. Great job by Southern putting hands on the basketball, and it goes the other way. Coming into the basketball game for Southern, it's going to be number 42, Brianna Thompson. And Coward also into the ball game, the senior from Fort Lauderdale. 38-31 the score. 1:54 remaining here in this first half of play. Inside pass taken away.
Good one-handed
steal. Connolly
steal.
Banks, absolutely. Nice job, shot up and no good by Paramore. She was trying to go in and get the foul. And coming away with the basketball is Charles for Southern University. Charles gets the basketball to Alyric Scott. One of the sophomores on this team. Now back to Charles. Charles will drive, kick it back out. Now Brittany Rose with the basketball. Towards the left side. She'll shoot a long three-pointer with three left on the shot clock. No good. And the rebound by Aria Williams. Williams takes the little European step. Goes up for the shot. Good!
Oh, she's holding her ankle.
Aria Williams is holding her ankle down on the floor. It looks like she's bouncing back up. Charles with the foul for Southern University. That'll be her first personal. 38-33 the score. Grambling trying to cut this deficit to four. Boy, I tell you what, you look at Ariel Williams and what she was able to do drawing that foul, and she fell awkwardly because as Charles fell down, she fell down on top of Charles, which caused her to have a little bit of an ankle twinge. But does she bounce back okay? Missed free throw there, and we talked about free throws. Another miss there on free throws.
Absolutely. Those will definitely kill you in a ball game.
The last time out, Grambling was 4 of 10 at the charity stripe, Southern 3 of 3. So they've had their opportunities at the line. Foul coming up against Grambling. That foul is against Justice Coleman. Second personal. Fourth team foul for the Southern Lady Jaguars. I should say for the Grambling Tigers. Gansey will come back into the ball game now for the Grambling Lady Tigers to take out Justice Coleman. Ooh, Paramore turns around. She might pick that ball off.
Definitely.
Brittany Rose, now defended by Aria Williams. Paramore picks her up on the zone. Rose goes in. Nice shot. That zone transition defense broke down after she was picked up by Paramore. She went around Paramore. There was no help on the backside, and she was able to get the bucket. Now 40-33, 28 seconds remaining in the half. Three-pointer, good, by Aria Williams out high on the right side, and it's now 40-36. Shot clock turned off, 19 seconds remaining. Charles with the basketball, 14 seconds. Paramore comes out on Charles, now 10 seconds. Charles looking right. A pick is set. Aria Williams picks her up. 6 seconds. Now to the left side to Brittany Rose. Left corner. There's 2 seconds. Here's a three-pointer. Up, no good. And we're at halftime. Halftime, the Lady Tigers trail 40-36 to Southern University. We'll take this timeout. We'll be right back right here on the Grambling Sports Radio Network and, of course, GSU TV. We'll talk, do y'all want to talk football in this segment? You want to talk football in this segment?
course, when it comes to that, just stay in their face and hope, you know.
As Grambling is back on the court, waiting for Southern to come back out, any other words you have to say to people?
Not really.
All right, we're going to take this short break. When we come back, we're going to have Grambling State basketball. You're listening to Grambling Sports Radio Network.
Welcome back here to the Frederick C. Hobby Assembly Center here on the campus of Grambling State University. The Grambling Lady Tigers losing right now to Southern University by the score of 40-36. We're going over to Reagan Higgins now to find out a little bit about the first half.
Maria Black, this is Reagan Higgins, and as we are observing this game tonight, the Lady Tigers came in strong with number 2 Shakyla Hill. She scored 2 points in the first minute. However, this is the Lady Jaguars came in with the intensity, and also they have been putting the pressure on Grambling. They lead with 21-14 in bench points, and they are currently leading the fourth. Beat them in defense as well as offense with intensity. And I'm going to throw it back to you, Centoria.
All right, thanks a lot, Reagan, joining us from the sideline. And, of course, you look back here in the second half, and Donovan, one of the most important things that's going to happen here is we saw that intensity really go up, as Reagan was talking about in the first half. But what has to happen now, Grambling has to match and surpass that intensity.
Absolutely. I was just going to point that out, as you just did, that the intensity was just unmatched. You know, Grambling came out, and you talked about they had to come out with a high tempo, and they had it. But as soon as that timeout was taken, the intensity just switched. And they're definitely going to need to be able to bring it back and start the second half.
All right, and we got a little bit of a problem here on the clock side, so they're going to inbound the basketball again.
Clock started, but the shot clock did not.
So they'll restart the third quarter here. And got a baby on the floor.
Baby with a basketball.
It happens. I've got a 4-year-old, so it happens. I think they're just gonna start all over again. I don't know. It happens.
Baby said, put me in, coach.
Put me in. I'm ready to go in the ball game. All right, now we're underway here in the second half. 40-36. Grambling with the basketball. Now going from right to left. Southern still out there, tough on defense. Shot up and good.
Justice Coleman with the shot. She now has 6 points, and it's now 40-38. Grambling taking this to a two-point deficit now. Shot up, no good. And that's going to be by number 24, Jaden Towner. Here comes Grambling. Ball nearly went out of bounds. Ariel Williams recovered, now gets out to Kyla Hill. Ooh, try to get it inside to Yancey, and the ball was tipped by Southern University. Outlet pass going to, of course, Towner. She goes in and gets the bucket.
Here comes Southern with that full court pressure again.
Oh, yeah, they're pressing hard. And then turnover. Skylar O'Bear gets it back over to Towner, and Towner gets the bucket. And now Grambling trailing 40-44-38. And the ball goes out of bounds off the hands of Dakara Parsons. Boy, it has really been tough in these first few possessions for the Grambling Lady Tigers.
Absolutely.
Now 8:45 remaining here in this third quarter of play. Three possessions, three turnovers for the Lady Tigers. Charles with the basketball. She's going to get it to Alyric Scott, and that's going to be a jump ball. Great defense by Grambling. Possession goes back to Southern. Well, you can watch on GSU TV, Takara Parsons getting her hand on the basketball, and it was all ball, too. Great job, because at first we thought it was going to be a foul, but she did a great job in getting her hand on the basketball. And the officials
trying to figure something out.
Yeah, the game and shot clock situation here. Had a chance to talk to former Grambling High star, not Lincoln Prep, but Grambling High star. Antonio Hudson had great years at LSU as a basketball player, was recruited. Of course, he played for Michael Lyons. Here is the Charles, gets the shot out, up and good. And that is Rashanti Cowart. ...46-38, now an 8-point deficit. Yancey got the ball tipped out of her hands. Now she gets it back over to Justice Coleman, and Coleman gets the shot. That almost was disastrous there for Grambling. 46-40 now. Grambling is trailing.
Could have been very disastrous.
7:48 remaining in the first or in the third quarter of play. Santoria Black along with Donovan Travis. Here's Charles with the shot up and good. Southern already has 10 points in the first 2.5 minutes. Oh, and Ariel Williams got her pocket picked by Skylar O'Bear. Up to Scott. Scott going in for the shot. No good. Ball tipped around. It's going to be a foul against Scott over the back. And for Scott, that'll be her first personal.
You know, looking at this full court press setup that Southern's running, it's actually a bit of a 1-2-2.
And Shekala Hill
made quick work of it.
Sure did. Got in and got the bucket. 48-42 now. Grambling trailing. 7:07 remaining here in this third quarter. Charles drives, shoots, and will draw the foul. And it looks like it'll go against Ariel Williams. That's her first personal. ...48-42 our score. Grambling is trailing. Charles will go to the free throw line for Southern University. Shot up off the back of the iron, no good. If you watch the replays, Charles went in for the shot and was hammered on the way around. That shot up and good. Into the ball game for the Lady Jags, Courtney Parson, the senior from Fort Lauderdale.
I haven't really heard too much from her this game.
Ariel Williams, who that last foul was on, of course, from Memphis, Tennessee, the sophomore with the Whitehaven High School. Shikali Hill getting it to Yancey. Nice job, Yancey. Oh, she tried to get it to Justice Coleman. It was tipped out of bounds by Southern. It'll go back to Grambling. Boy, we should see some high flying in the next ball game between Grambling and Southern. Southern right now, 1-14. Shikali Hill goes up. Shot is up and no good. Boy, she spends more time on the hardwood because just being knocked down and going in and just really being aggressive. And you look at her, and she tries to go in and make plays happen, drawing fouls. And 9 times out of 10, when she gets fouled, she's going to the line.
Exactly. You can't fault her at all for her aggressiveness, because if she goes down, more times than not, she's definitely going to get back up.
Lady Tigers trailing 49-43 now after the made bucket. Spin to the line going into the ball game today, 75 times going into the ball game today.
She just made both free throws there. So we got a foul. That foul's going to be on Parsons. That's her third.
Ooh, don't need that. Shot up, no good.
Still Grambling, still Southern's ball, excuse me.
Prairie View, number one in the conference in offense right now, averaging over 64 points a game. Grambling, 57 points. Southern, actually, seventh in the conference, averaging 56.5 points a game. At the very bottom of the conference is Arkansas Pine Bluff, one of the teams in the top five that you wouldn't expect right now. Mississippi Valley, fourth in the conference in scoring.
Oh, wow.
Brittany Rose, a three-pointer on the way, no good off the iron. It's tipped out of bounds, and it will go back to Grambling. 49-44, Grambling with this 5-point deficit, and 1-point and 8-point deficit for the Lady Tigers. And now, I think you were, had it right, a 1-2-2 press set up really well by the Lady Jags. Justice Coleman stepping inside the 3-point line on the left side, shot up and good. Justice Coleman with the shot. It's now 49-46, back down to a 3-point deficit. Brittany Rose now with the basketball. Bounce pass on the inside. It's going to be Southern with a shot up. No good. Ball tipped around. And it's recovered with the basketball. Courtney Parson. Now she gets it to Brittany Rose, who's defended by Shikali Hill. Shot up. No good. She gets the rebound over the head of Shikali Hill. Shot goes back up. No good. Ball tipped around. Justice Coleman tried to get it. No good. And Alaric Scott with the basketball. Southern getting multiple chances at the rim. Just getting the boards on the offensive glass. Here's the drive by Towner, up and good. 5 opportunities, and they finally get a bucket. 51-46, back to the zone, back to the press. Shot up, no good. Off balance shot by Banks. She had the shot, but she was off balance when she took it. Parson with the basketball, the senior from Fort Lauderdale. She's defended by Aria Williams. Parson will drive. She's at the free throw line, taking the shot from the right elbow. Up, no good. Rebound and the putback, good. Tanera Moore with the bucket. And a steal by Southern, and the official falls down. And that's going to be a foul coming up against Southern. Ooh, looks like the official's about to walk that one off. She hit the ground hard.
I saw that.
We have a timeout on the floor with the score. The Grambling Lady Tigers trailing 53-46 with 4:43 remaining here in this third quarter play. We'll take this 1 minute timeout. We'll be right back on the Grambling Sports Radio Network.
App is here, and the features make it 100 times easier for you to navigate through the semester. Get direct access to your grades, student email, your Tiger One card, news, the KGRM radio station, campus events, local weather, and more. There's even a map that'll show you exactly where you are on campus so that you can get to where you need to be. In your free time, you can stay up to date with the latest social media posts from the Grambling State University Instagram, Facebook, and Twitter. So head over to the App Store and download the Grambling State mobile app today.
What is Grambling? Grambling is growing. It's a community. Grambling is an education, an experience. Grambling is legacy, tradition, and the future. What is Grambling? Grambling is all of this and more. Grambling is the place where everybody is somebody.
All right, Southern University at the free throw line. Shot up, no good. And the rebound by Southern University, coming down with the rebound is Markeisha Bodie, the 5'11 freshman from Birmingham. Grambling had a hard time getting it across the timeline, and finally they do. Justice Coleman with the basketball. Pops it back out to Ariel Williams. She drives. Now to Shekala Hill. Hill goes in for the shot, no good. Well, you look at some of these numbers, and the one that's most disturbing, 6 of 13 from the free throw line, and now Grambling will get a shot at the charity stripe once again.
You want to know another scary stat?
Yep.
17 turnovers.
Ooh.
17.
Not a stat that Coach Freddie Murray is going to take lightly after this game. Of course, if they are fortunate.
Skylar makes her first free throw. Grambling brings back in Jasmine Forte. Hopefully she can give a lot of size on the inside on defense now.
Free throw up and good. Better than 70% free throw shooter. She struggled a little bit early today. 2 for 2 at the line on that trip. 4:18 remaining in the first half for in the third quarter. Imani McWilliams back in the ball game. She takes a three up, good. And you can see her family cheering in section 115. She's got a cheering crew here. Of course, a lot of her aunts and uncles have come. Of course, they're from the Lincoln Parish area. And Ariel Williams turns the ball over for Grambling. I asked Chris McWayne, her dad. I says, you know, you've been a Grambling fan a long time. I says, now watching your daughter play for the blue and gold. I says, how do you do that? Because you've been a Grambling fan. He says, hey, my baby plays for the blue and gold. That's what I'm cheering for. But you notice the colors that they have on? They're almost black and gold.
Almost. Almost. Definitely more gold than anything else.
Yeah, you got some Grambling hats in there. That's for sure. Three-pointer by Skylar O'Bear. It's up and good. 57-48, 60-48 the score. Now a double-digit deficit for the Lady Tigers. 3:27 remaining in this third quarter. Yancey with the ball. Gets it over to Cameron London. Inside to Forte. Forte gets the bucket.
And one.
Well, you know, you got a player like Forte. And Skylar O'Bear comes over and has to talk to Coach Funches for a minute because she was really furious about the last foul call on her. Free throws up, rattles in and out, no good. And Brittany Rose with the rebound. She gets it to Charles. Shot up no good, and here comes Chicala Hill.
With the cross.
Cameron London for three. Ooh, no good. Yancey with the rebound. She goes up. Can't hit it off the backboard. She goes up again for the shot. It's good. That's how you stay with it.
Clean up your own mess.
Inside. Nice tip there by Forte. Cameron London with the ball. Chicala Hill almost shook herself. Goes in for the shot. No good. Shot up. No good. McLean tried to get the rebound. Chicala Hill recovers. And now McLean will be one-on-one with Chicala Hill. And we got a foul coming up. Looks like Moore is going to pick up the foul. Baltimore, Maryland native. Two-shot foul now here for Jasmine Forte. Shot up and, ooh, no good off the back of the iron. Struggles at the free throw line from time to time. And Coach Murray says he wants her to improve on those free throws. High arcing shot off. Nope, doesn't hit the rim. No good. '60-52. 2 minutes remaining here in this third quarter of play. Three-pointer on the way, no good. Rebounding the putback, no good. Moore trying to get the ball in. Here comes Chicala Hill off the steal. Chicala Hill to Cameron London. Three-pointer, no good. Boy, London struggling. Ball tipped around. They say he was off of Southern. Back to Grambling.
I tell you one thing. Grambling got lucky on that one because they had two people both going after the ball. So definitely no communication there as far as getting that board.
Lady Tiger basketball. Forte controlling. Now to Justice. Oh, and the ball was thrown into traffic to try to get it to Cameron London. She was cutting across the baseline. 60-52 the score. Grambling trailed at one point by 12 points. Brittany Rose coming out of the ball game for Southern. Chicala Hill turns, shoots, good. Pretty good defense on her by McWayne, but nothing you can do about that.
A natural scorer, Chicala Hill is.
Charles with the basketball. 60-54, Grambling cutting the lead now to six. 1:15 remaining in the third quarter. Charles now will come to the base, to the free throw line. Back out to McWayne, a three-pointer, no good. Ball is rebounded by Cameron London. She loses the ball. Ball is on the floor, jump ball, and possession will go to Grambling. '60-54 the score. Brittany Rose comes back into the ballgame now for the Lady Jags. Santoria Black along with Donovan McCray. And you know, Donovan, you and Malik talked a little bit about the AFC and NFC divisional round here. And I don't know, it's going to be interesting today between this whole weekend. You look at Kansas City and the Chargers. I'm hoping for Andy Reid. I really am.
Well, Kansas City is actually up on the Colts right now. Just the start of the second quarter, 14-0. As I see, look over my shoulder, Malik is actually watching the game right now.
And by the way, it is snowing cats and dogs in Kansas City. All kinds of snow and stuff. That definitely plays in the hands of Kansas City. Yancey with the basketball.
Oh, and it's tipped out. A steal by Southern.
Right back to Grambling.
Grambling with a steal. Yancey inside. It's going to be an offensive foul charge to Forte.
Got it for hooking.
Got some news. Nice little tidbit here from the professor, Nick Harrison, who does some things with us at Red Peach Radio from time to time. And of course, he's a product of Grambling High School before it was Lincoln Prep. And know the McWanes personally. Amani McWane's mom and dad are Grambling High School sweethearts.
Oh, wow.
Yeah.
Interesting.
Southern with the basketball. Cameron London playing defense on the ball. And a steal by Grambling. Great defense by London. London with a three-pointer up. Good! Cameron London with the three-pointer to end the third quarter.
That just may be the spark that they need going into the fourth quarter.
60-57 to score. The Grambling Lady Tigers cutting it to three. We'll take this timeout. We'll be right back. Lady Tigers trail by three to Southern University. You're watching this game live on GSU TV and on Sports Talk 97.7. I think we're having a little technical difficulty as the sound is off on the microphone, it looks like. And a near steal here by Shekinah Hill. Yancey playing good defense on Brittany Rose. ...60-57 to score, Grambling with the basketball. And a steal by Southern coming away with the basketball is Courtney Parson, shot up. Good. It looks like it's going to be good. Yep, they're going to count the bucket.
And that foul is going to be against Shekinah. Looks like it's going to be her fourth.
Well, you can watch that on the replay there, and you can tell that's a little iffy right there.
I'll tell you one thing. Shekinah, four fouls, and we just started the fourth quarter.
That's tough. And so you know that they're going to go right at her on defense.
Absolutely.
Free throw up, good.
Shot is up and good by Cameron London.
...63-59, Cameron London, a couple of big buckets here as of late. Shot up and good.
That was number 24 for Southern, Jaden Tower. Towner, excuse me.
Grambling with the basketball, 65-59. Cameron, that's Justice.
Answering right back.
Justice Coleman with the bucket. Southern University with the basketball on top, 65-61. Drive and the layup, good. That's Courtney Parson with the bucket. Up, a steal there by Southern. That comes away to Brianna Thompson. Justice Coleman is going to get the foul here.
That brings the total for turnovers for Grambling to 21.
Wow. Second team foul, Justice Coleman with three now. That's tough when you got your star player with four right now and you still got 7:55 left to go in the ball game.
And especially anybody that knows Shekinah knows she loves to go after those steals, especially those behind the back swipes. So.
Oh, yeah. And this is where you miss a Jasmine Boyd.
No question.
Charles with a basketball. Bounce pass. Shot up, layup is good by Lyric Scott, the sophomore. She now has 4 points in the ball game. Well, if you go back and you look at this ball game, one of the main things you look at, 8 for 18 from the free throw line. Cameron London going up for the shot, no good. Went off the iron. Southern coming away with the basketball, 69-61. 7:13 remaining here in this fourth quarter. Skylar O'Bear, been a little quiet here in the second half. She did some damage in the second quarter with three consecutive triples. O'Bear, back to the middle, right side to Charles. Charles, shot from the right elbow, no good as the shot clock expires. And here comes Shekinah Hill. Hill gets her pocket picked by Southern University. Shot is up good, and cheating. Of course, she was not going to contest that with four fouls.
Can't risk it at all.
Now back to a 10-point lead. They had this down to four. Shekinah Hill with the basketball, and of course, they've got to make the return trip down to Baton Rouge, which is always tough to play in. And a foul out high on Southern, and that foul is going to go against the Lyric Scott. When you look at the scoring here in the ball game, you've got three players in double figures for Southern, led by Skylar O'Bear with 13. Shekinah Hill, 15.7 rebounds. She's got 8 turnovers. But you know, when you handle the basketball a lot, sometimes you turn the ball over. Brittany Rose coming in. She's a transfer from Copiah Lincoln Community College. And the official whistles. The ball back in play. Ariel Williams with the basketball. Three-pointer by Justice Coleman, no good. Ooh. And Brittany Rose with the rebound. And it's going to be a foul charge to Southern.
Like an illegal screen on O'Bear. That's her fifth foul.
Wow.
She's out the game.
That is her fifth personal foul and the leading scorer on this Southern University team. And one of the top defenders is now fouled out of the ball game. That's a huge blow for Southern now.
Trying to find somebody to...
Well, they're taking their time. They're taking their time.
I believe it. Finishes the game with 16 points.
Once a player fouls out of the ball game, they tell the timekeeper to set the clock either 30 or 60 seconds. And then once they do that, the team has that long in order to replace that player. Mm. Justice Coleman in the game along with Shekinah Hill, Ariel Williams. Well, Williams is...
should say, Shakala Hill is really being played tough. Rebound up and good by Ariel Williams, 71-63.
Like a streak of lightning just came in and got that offensive board.
Shot is up and good.
That was a tough layup by Charles for Southern.
Charles with the basketball comes across the half court line. She's on the left side out high, defended by Takara Parsons. Pick setup, and Charles drives in for the layup. That was a perfect pick setup. Charles goes back around the backside, no one at home, and gets the layup. And Ariel Williams is fouled. And that's going to be a foul on Towner. We have a timeout on the floor with the score. Grambling trailing Southern University 75-63. 4:43 remaining here in the ball game. We'll take this timeout. You're listening to the Grambling Sports Radio Network and watching this game live on GSU TV. Welcome back here to the Frederick C. Hobby Assembly Center on the campus of Grambling State University. Lady Tigers trailing by 12 right now, 75-63, 4:43 remaining here in this ball game. And Donovan Travis joining us here at courtside. And Donovan, you know, one of the main things that, you know, if you're the Lady Tigers, that you got to do is you cannot turn the ball over. That's not an over and back violation. Great no call by the officials.
As they almost did right there.
Cameron London for three, cutting this now to 9.
I'll tell you one thing. Southern is going to be in no rush as we get to the last 4.5 minutes of the game to put up any shots.
23 turnovers by the Lady Tigers.
My goodness.
75-66. Cameron London coming up big for the Lady Tigers. She's now in double figures with 11 points. Third Lady Tigers in double figures. Justice Coleman with 12 and Shakala Hill with 15. Shot up by Southern, no good. Rebound by Takara Parsons. And a foul coming up on Southern. That foul on number 22 Moore. Inbounding the basketball is Ariel Williams, getting it to Shakala Hill. Justice Coleman with the shot up, no good. Boy, she was way off on that one.
Missed everything.
Southern with the basketball, 3:49 remaining in the ballgame, 75-66. Nice pick. Southern goes in for the shot. No good. 3 seconds left on the shot clock. Southern will go to the line to shoot free throws. Two shots coming up here second foul on Forte. Two shots coming up for Southern University. At the line is Courtney Parson, the 5'7 senior from Fort Lauderdale, Florida. Men's game coming up after this one. Shot up, no good. Nobody there. Luckily, the ball goes awry. Here comes Shakyla Hill off the rebound. Hill driving, and she's going to be fouled. Great defense there by Towner. But she hit the arm of Shakyla Hill. And Hill will try to cut this deficit down to 8 points. Fifteen for Shakyla Hill, 9 rebounds, 7 assists. First free throw is up and good.
Not to mention the 4 fouls that she has as well.
Yeah, she's got 4 fouls. She's a double digits in a category that she does not like to be in, and that is turnovers. 10 turnovers in the ballgame. Lady Tigers still have time left, though, a world of time. 3:18 remaining. Shot up and good. In the ballgame now for the Lady Tigers, Paramore. Paramore will defend the inbound pass.
Tried to take the inbound.
Yeah, she really did. And the ball gets turned over. Justice Coleman gets the ball. Oh, Justice Coleman with a bad pass, trying to get it to Cameron London. And it's a turnover. Southern gets it back. 76-68 the score. Grambling trailing, 2:57 remaining in the ballgame. Now Southern trying to milk the clock a little bit. Still 15 seconds left on the shot clock. Shot up, no good. Shot clock violation. Goes back to Grambling. So good defense there by the Lady Tigers. Now they got to turn that into points.
I tell you, if you don't start some, you got to start it ASAP.
Like right now, sooner than yesterday, quicker than right now. And hey. Shakyla Hill got her pocket picked. And she loses her shoe. Timeout on the floor. We'll take a timeout as well. Oh, we'll keep it right here. 76-68 the score. Grambling trailing, 2:23 remaining in the game. Lady Tigers really have struggled here today. Turnovers have been a big thing. The other thing is, they're winning the rebounding edge here, Donovan, which is really the puzzling thing. They're winning the rebounding side, not shooting well from the free throw line. And then you look at points off the turnovers, 28-8 in favor of Southern.
Yeah, that's a stat that'll definitely kill you. 28-8, not doing anybody any favors.
We'll take a timeout here, 76-68, 2:23 remaining. We'll be right back on the Grambling Sports Radio Network and GSU TV. Back here at the Frederick C. Hobby Assembly Center, the Lady Tigers trail 76-68. 3-point shot on the way as the shot clock expires, no good. And that's one of the things that they've been told is to run that shot clock down. Grambling trailing by 8 and a foul coming up on Southern. That foul's going to be charged to Southern University. 76-68 the score. Are they taking another timeout here?
I think the refs are about to discuss something.
Yep, they are. But while we have this opportunity, let's tell you about an event that'll be coming up. The Grambling Legends Incorporated will hold the inaugural Willis Reed Basketball Classic January the 18th here at the Frederick C. Hamdi Assembly Center. The Lincoln Prep Panthers will host the classic in honor of two-time NBA champion and NBA Hall of Famer, Grambling Legends Hall of Famer, and Grambling alumnus Willis Reed. Scotlandville, Ravel, Woodlawn, and Lincoln Prep will all be in, will participate in the classic. The tickets can be purchased at the Hobby Assembly Center on the day of the event. Tickets are $8 for adults, $5 for students. Games will begin at 5:30 p.m. So that should be a nice event coming up here January the 18th.
Oh, yes.
'76-'68 the score. Lady Tigers trailing with a minute 46 remaining. And looking at the replay there, you can see the Southern Lady Jaguars defensively mugging Shakala Hill. And it wasn't so much the trip, it was the arm that they were looking at. They got her arm and pulled it back. And so now Lady Tigers will have the opportunity to try to get a couple here with a minute 46 remaining in the ball game. And every free throw is going to count here. You know, you're 8 for 18. You got to try to turn that around. And this has been really one of those tough games for the Lady Tigers. You know, going into that last full timeout before this one, the Lady Tigers were outscored 15-6. And just think, they were up in the first quarter 23-18, and then Southern went on a tear.
Yep. Not much you can really say. Just got you look at some stats such as turnovers, free throws. That'll tell you everything you need to know.
Shakala Hill with two big free throws here to try to get this lead down to 6.
First one is good.
One more opportunity at the line. One more free throw at the line.
She missed. Oh, no.
Missed the free throw.
7-point game.
Southern with the basketball. They're working this clock down as much as they can.
They're going to get Paramore for the foul.
Yep. Southern University with that basketball, 29 left on the shot clock, so you know they are really working this down.
No rush at all.
Shot up and good. They work the clock down and they get the bucket. 78-69, 9-point deficit, under a minute to go. Shot up and good. Parsons with the bucket, and Grambling takes a timeout. 78-69, 51 seconds remaining in the ballgame. Lady Tigers take a 30-second timeout. And Donovan, if you're the Lady Tigers, Southern's going to come back here after this timeout with the basketball. Do you start fouling or you just try to play good defense?
Right now, I say they take a gamble and try to steal it on the inbound. But at the same time, if they miss it, they're going to have to probably start playing the foul game.
Southern with the basketball. Grambling with the full court press. 46 seconds remaining in the game. Southern getting across the half court line. 7-point deficit for the Lady Tigers. Justice Coleman with the foul. That's her fourth personal. Shot up and good.
Got to work fast now if you want any chance.
Shekala Hill loses the ball off of her shoe, recovers. Paramore with the bucket, 34 seconds remaining in the game. Shot up, no good. She draws the foul, though. '80-71 the score, 33 seconds remaining in the game. Shot up, good. Lady Tigers still got 33 seconds left, but they're going to need a miracle right now. They get this, it'll still be a three-possession ball game. As it'll be down by seven if they can hit this free throw. Free throw is up and good. Foul coming up. This one's going to be on Body with the foul. Cameron London getting ready to come back in, as well as Paramore. Shot up, no good. 80-73. And Lady Tigers, looks like they may go to 2-1 in conference play. And that's tough losing to Southern here because, again, you got to go back down there to start the second half of the season.
Right.
81-73, timeout, Grambling. And I believe it's the 32nd timeout, 81-73 the score. So while he has had this opportunity, 81-73 the score, Grambling Lady Tigers trailing, 29 seconds remaining. Malik, I know, has been watching the game over there. What, do you have an update on the score?
Malik, you have any updates on the football game right now? Give us 1 second.
Lady Tigers again will play Alcorn State University Monday night, 5:30 p.m. is the tip-off.
Looking at the update right now, inside 2 minutes, almost going to the half. Chiefs up on the Colts, 17-7.
Andy Reid, a.k.a. the Walrus, may get a win in the playoffs, but it's just halftime.
Right.
Lady Tigers still with 30 seconds remaining. Paramore for three. Good! 81-76, five-point deficit. And Justice Coleman fouls, and that's five on her. Yeah, if that's Justice Coleman, that's five on her. Lady Tigers. Of course, there'll be a two-shot foul. Two-shot foul coming up. Justice Coleman out of the game with 12. Ooh, shot up off the front of the iron. Still a chance here for the Lady Tigers. Got an NBA shot clock left. 81-76. Two-possession ball game. Alaric with the free throw up and good. Shekala Hill
Up the floor, Cameron London for three. Shot is up. Good! Timeout Grambling, 82-79 with 19 seconds left in the game.
Not over yet.
Marit Brown Clark wrote a song called It Ain't Over. 30-second timeout here, 82-79. Lady Tigers trail by three. Well, I tell you what, Donovan, we have seen this Lady Tiger basketball team down 12, now bringing it back to three. And, you know, just when you think, okay, well, doesn't look like the Lady Tigers are going to be able to pull this one out, now all of a sudden, the Lady Tigers, tough defense, and Cameron London has come up big.
Absolutely. And, you know, the unsung hero, you know, with Jasmine Boyd being out, somebody had to step up, as you said, and everybody's stepping up, but that's one name that you can't deny this game.
Yeah.
Just as you said, they were about to go to 2-1. We still we can't think it's over just yet.
82-79, Lady Tigers still with a chance. It'll be Lady Jags basketball out of bounds.
Grambling is out of timeouts now, though, so that can be another key.
Brittany Rose inbounding the basketball. Are they going to trap her, or are they going to call a foul? I believe Yancey's going to be called with the foul.
16 seconds. You didn't have time to hope for a turnover and tried to get a foul instantly.
Charles is getting ready to check into the basketball game. That's for defense. I think the Jags, Lady Jags, still have two timeouts, and Brittany Rose with the first free throw. And now Charles comes in. And don't forget, Grambling with no timeouts. Lady Jags with two. Now a two-possession ball game, Donovan.
Work fast.
Second free throw up and good. Five-point deficit. Lady Tigers at the basketball. Shekala Hill will press, and they're going to have a foul here. Oh, did...
Of course
it goes in from half court. She throws it up from half court as she was fouled, and it's no good.
And everybody wants it to count.
Of course it goes in.
Of course they want it to count.
Unbelievable. Now they're going to bring in some help for rebounding. Two-shot foul coming up for the Lady Tigers. Shekala Hill here, 84-79. And I understand I completely understand the thought process behind this.
The first free throw is made. Second free throw is good.
84-81. And a near steal. And a foul coming up. They got to save time. And who's the foul on? Looks like Takara Parsons. I was looking, and all of a sudden I saw a basketball team come in. That's the Woodlawn Knights from Shreveport. Mm. And their head coach, former Grambling State University standout Kenny Sykes. In the 1993-94 season, Kenny Sykes and Kevin Granger were both in the top five in scoring in the nation.
Wow.
Kevin Granger, of course, played for Robert Moreland at Texas Southern. Kenny Sykes for Aaron James at Grambling State University. Sykes was heavily recruited, of course, by the NBA. And at that point in time, former recruiter and then, of course, now former basketball coach Larry Wright recruited, was actually scouting Kenny Sykes to come play with the New Jersey Nets, whose general manager at that time was Willis Reed. And now a timeout after two free throws, 86-81 with 11 seconds remaining in the ball game. And this is a 30-second timeout taken by Southern University. 30-second timeout taken by Southern University, 86-81. Grambling is trailing by five. 11 seconds remaining in this ball game, and you know, if you're Grambling, you can only hope for turnovers and a three-pointer.
Missed free throws.
That's all you can hope for.
So now here's the thing. Do you go for a three, or do you try to get a quick two? It's because either way, it's still going to be a one-possession ball game.
Yeah. That's like saying, do you go for the field goal or the touchdown first? Mm. Kyler Hill will pick up the basketball after the quick timeout. And they elect to go for the two-point bucket. It's up, no good. Sha'Kala Hill couldn't hit that shot. And Rose will now pass the ball up, and that's the ball game. Final score. Lady Tigers lose a tough one by the score of 86-81. Men's basketball game coming up next. We'll take this two-minute timeout, 2 minutes. You're listening to the Grambling Sports Radio Network on Sports Talk 97.7, and you're watching it live on GSU TV. We'll be right back.
Hey, Malik, do me a favor and get Coach
Murray.
Coach Murray, right there. As soon as the alma mater's over with, bring him over for the interview.
I got to get up anyway, so.
I'm going to have to switch